Good morning, church. I'd like to continue a thought from yesterday. It's a kind of a short thought from Romans 12, 14, and we touched on it, but I want to touch on it more, maybe a little more deeply today. Bless them that persecute you, bless and curse not. And here's the thought I want to leave with you today. When you bless your persecutors, you're taking control of your life. Some of you know I used to teach traffic school back in the 90s part-time when I was pastoring in San Jose. I took this thought. I said, when you let someone into traffic in front of you and you don't lose your cool, you're taking control of your life. When you allow someone to tick you off, then you're letting them push the buttons in your life. You're giving them control of your life. Anytime you place your emotions in the hands of someone else or judge and determine your responses based upon their actions, you are giving control away. Now, among Christians, there are those who consider that anyone who takes the Sermon on the Mount seriously to be weak and ineffective, even among Christians, believe it or not. The most commonly watered-down words of Jesus in American pulpits are those in the Sermon on the Mount, where he teaches against retaliation, and he urges his disciples to go the extra mile, to turn the other cheek, and to live a life of radical love. So I'm going to recommend that to you today. I'm going to try to reverse that a little bit. What people seldom understand is that Jesus is actually empowering us with these teachings. You see, the world seems to believe that it's possible to push people's buttons and produce a predictable reaction in the form of a behavior or attitude. Don't you know that people who try to push your buttons are really after the response, the reaction that makes you angry? That causes you to want to retaliate. It's push, 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 push. That's a technique. Don't give them that power. Jesus taught us to be led, controlled, and empowered by what? Other people? No, by the Holy Spirit. By our gut reactions? No, by the Spirit. Paul expounded upon those lessons, and he admonished kingdom people to live beyond and above the control of those who would manipulate them by words and attacks. So, whatever anyone does to you or says to you or does or says to me, we're indwelt by the Holy Spirit and liberated by Jesus Christ to have choices in all of our circumstances. And if the situation seems to call for a response in kind, the Christian is free from and above that law. We do not have to respond in kind. No one has that control over us. We are controlled and empowered by Jesus Christ and by His love. We are free from that kind of law. We can return love for hate, blessing for curses, grace for harsh judgment. There is nothing that your enemy can do to rob you of that choice. They can't beat you down. They can't stop you from loving them, no matter how hard they try. Under Jesus Christ, you have taken control of the situation by taking control of your choices, and He empowers you to do that. You've won. You're a people of victory. This is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Short one today. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and be gracious to you and give you His peace. The peace that passes understanding. Not as the world gives He unto us. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Amen.